Hello, everybody, and welcome to today's member spotlight. Today, we're talking to our friend Marc Poulos. Marc is a long-time member of the Institute. He's executive director of the Indiana, Illinois, Iowa Foundation for Fair Contracting. He's based out of Chicago, Illinois, and he's been in his position since 2016. Marc, welcome to today's member spotlight. And if you could just tell the folks about the IIIFFC.
Hey, thanks for having me, Andrew. Really appreciate the opportunity to represent WCRI. As you said, I've been a longstanding member on your advisory board and have appreciated that relationship. I've been with IIIFFC since 2016. Really started there as their associate general counsel back in 2003 and then started as their director in 16 and been doing work with them for nearly 20 years. IIIFFC, we're the labor management group of the Operating Engineers Local 150, which is the heavy equipment operators union out of Chicago, Illinois. I think they're now the second largest operating engineer local in the country. Wow. They represent about 23,000 members over there. They went from about 8,000 members in 1986 and have grown exponentially in 2023 to a little over 23,000 members. So we represent the interests of both the 23,000 members as well as the thousands of contractors that they have signatory to collective bargaining agreements. So as you can imagine, when it comes to workers' compensation, labor management, that perspective, I think is important, right? Looking at what it takes to protect individuals and workers' compensation systems, and at the same time, keeping it, affordable and a good system for employers as well.
Fantastic. Well, Marc, as you know, we asked four questions in our member spotlight. So the first one I'd ask is, how did you first learn about WCRI?
Yeah, so that was a little over a decade ago. Illinois had embarked, Illinois was in a problem state with workers' compensation. I mean, every conversation that you got in from labor and management really centered around workers' compensation, rising costs, frequency of injuries, duration of injuries, lack of individuals around the state that could treat individuals. The list went on. So I had learned about WCRI during our omnibus workers' comp revamp a little more than a decade ago, and really used the kind of sort of dynamic up-to-date analysis of workers' compensation systems around the Midwest, and used that as one of the bases to negotiate some of the workers' comp reforms that were done in Illinois a little more than a decade ago.
Great. And so since joining WCRI, what is the value that you get from being a member?
Yeah, well, first of all, you get kind of sort of the firsthand look at the CompScope, and you get the firsthand look and actually get to make some of the comments on some of the work that's done through WCRI. But more than anything, it's just the analysis that's done, right? It's the analysis, it's looking at the trends, it's looking at other jurisdictions, it's looking at whether you've got a fee schedule or not a fee schedule, how is that stacking up as it relates to other jurisdictions, looking at frequencies, looking at types of injuries, which is extremely important when it comes to building trades. I mean, it is a construction industry is a unfortunately high risk industry, and workers' compensation does play a role in a lot of those daily activities of those individuals. So in terms of the value add, it's really looking at that comparative analysis and then being able to use that information to make tweaks to the law that makes it better for workers, but at the same time makes it fair for the employers.
And if you had a favorite WCRI study or research area, what would it be for you?
I would say it's probably the comparative analysis of states. As I said, as it relates to cost, frequency. It's interesting when I first discovered WCRI, you would see all of these charts and graphs, and Illinois, boy, would be at one side of the chart and graph. And it was always like, boy, I would love to see us on the other side of the chart and graph. And when I say it was the one side, it was not good. Right. State of Illinois had a high cost, a high frequency, high duration or long duration. Yeah. It just wasn't in the right frame for workers' comp. And it's interesting that over the years, I always want us to be on the other side. In reality, really where you kind of want to be is in the middle. And throughout, the analysis that WCRI has done and the reforms we've done in Illinois, that's kind of sort of where we've gotten to, more in the middle than to the left or right.
Great. And I think you'd mentioned too, I think in the earlier answer, that one of your favorites was the CompScope studies And you are a member of the WCRI Illinois Advisory Committee. You're one of the members that sits on this committee with a number of other stakeholders, labor, government, employers, insurers, medical practitioners, and help us vet our research, our CompScope studies, our medical benchmarks and CompScope benchmarks, which are comprehensive reference reports that measure the performance of 17 state workers' compensation systems, including Illinois, how they compare with each other and how they have changed over time. I know your feedback on that committee has been tremendously helpful, not only in terms of the perspective of what's going on in the state, but also looking ahead. I know one example is when you're talking about all the billions of dollars that's going into infrastructure in Illinois, and also letting us know that, hey, this could be, we could see an uptick in claims as a lot of new hires are coming in and very, very dangerous job, as you've already mentioned.
So I would say two things. One, not only an influx of the state spending, but influx in the federal spending. And then, interestingly enough, emerging industries too. You have in the state of Illinois and really around the country this change in how we're going to build the electrical grid, for example, right? Relying more on renewables, wind farm and solar fields. I mean, these are things that are emerging industries, a carbon capture, things that require deep well, down a mile into the earth's surface, drilling, things that we haven't really seen in the past. So, what happens when you have new emerging industries? Well, you have new emerging unfortunate incidences that occur as well. That has a direct effect on, individuals and frequency and duration and cost of workers' compensation. And the like. So, the advisory committee, having such a diverse membership and everybody sharing, I think, quite freely in those meetings and hearing different perspectives, right, from people that are actually treating physicians or people that are actually, from organizations that have, that aren't building trades related to, right, grocery stores or drug stores or, other individuals from other industries. Right. Interesting to hear their perspectives as well.
Well said. And our last question, Mark, can you describe a moment when WCRI's research was really helpful?
I think I mentioned it before, but we've had not just a decade plus ago workers' comp reform, but throughout the last 10 or 12 years, we've had a couple different reforms. I do the vast majority of lobbying on behalf of labor and management in the state of Illinois for building trades, and particularly for operating engineers, Local 150, and the thousands of contractors that they have as signatory contractors as well. So when I'm going to Springfield and lobbying for these efforts, having the knowledge and the dynamic and up-to-date analysis of how we stack up, it makes it extremely helpful to come with that perspective. And quite honestly, really an expertise in the workers' comp world that I really didn't have before I became a member of WCRI.
Well, Mark, we're glad to have you. So thank you so much for your time today. And thank you for your ongoing support of the Institute as a member, as well as a member of one of our advisory committees. So thank you so much, Mark.
Appreciate it. Thanks, Andrew.